Well, guys, here we are. NHL 20 has come out, and while many things have been changed, there is one glaring thing which remains the same. Be a Pro, the forgotten game mode, the game mode that could be something very special and fun if just a little bit more effort was put into it. What's up, guys? My name is Syn, and in this video, I'm gonna go over a few of the ideas I have that will turn this mode into more than just a senseless grind of gameplay. But I can't do it alone. I'm gonna need your guys' help, so go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't already. Now, we all know that a story mode would be amazing. Cut scenes like Madden or 2K, they look fantastic. But in this, I'm just focusing on the gameplay and how to make this mode better without going over the top in cosmetics. So actually what I've done, I've created a bit of a priority list, and the thing about these changes is, for EA's sake, none of these seem like they would be very hard to implement, but they would add a whole new level of immersion to this game mode to make it more playable and more replayable. That is the most important thing. Replayability in video games these days is a must. So if you guys are ready, I'm ready. Let's get into it. Here are my proposed changes for NHL Be a Pro. And what better place to start than the beginning? We need some more get started options. After you get your player created and all set up, you get a screen that looks like this with three different options of how you can start your career. You can start in the Memorial Cup, you can choose the team that will draft you, or you can play in the CHL and choose an age. Now, while these are some decent options, what about the rest of the world? So why is it that we can't start in Scandinavia or Europe or maybe even Russia? I guess licensing might be an issue with some of these, but as you can see here, a lot of these teams already exist in the game. Now, yes, there is a conflict. Maybe we don't have the correct schedules, but as we can see in franchise modes, those schedules can be auto-generated, so I'm sure that a program and coding could be made up to fix that issue. All in all, this gives a lot more variety in how you want to start your career, which will, once again, just add to the immersion of this game mode. Continuing on, I think it would be great to have more starting overall choices for your player. As of right now, you're giving a pretty cookie cutter setup, and it's just based on your player type and what option you chose. If you chose CHL, your age, if it's younger, you'll be lower overall. If you chose Memorial Cup or, you know, drafted by a team, you'll start up a bit higher overall, but you're never above 70 overall, which I think is insane. What if you want to be a top 10 draft pick? You should be able to start at a higher overall. Or maybe you want to be an undrafted player looking to cut his teeth and earn his way into the league. If you're 20, 21 years old, you know, maybe you should give around the 70s overall to be able to prove yourself on AHL teams. So my suggestion as a remedy for this is a tiered overall system. And keep in mind, these would obviously only apply to the amateur start options. The first tier would be 55 to 60 overall, and this would be considered a late round pick. Now, obviously, as you grow throughout the year, you can kind of improve upon those draft rankings, but you should be down there pretty far. The next tier would be 60 to 65 overall, considered more of a mid-round pick, and combined with the growth throughout the year, should land you somewhere in those middle rounds. The next tier is the early round draft pick, 65 to 70 overall starting out. You should be able to at least get into the second round and probably even maybe into the first with the growth and your performance over the year. And the final and highest tier is considered a top prospect, 70 to 75 starting overall. Now, with your growth and performance throughout the year, you could get up towards 80 and maybe even past 80 overall. But you see that all the time in the draft and franchise mode. Those top guys in the top 10 and the top 5, high starting overalls, great potential. So why can't this be an option? Why can't we have a stud? This is a single player game mode. Be a Pro is for fun. The more options we have, the more room to have fun and create our own story and narratives for our pros. Like in any great game out there, if you have more control over customization, and that's not just the cosmetic side, more control over the customization of who you're gonna be rather than what you look like, the game mode becomes infinitely more immersive. Now, after you create your player and get the league all started, you're taken to a screen that looks like this. This is the menu, the main menu. for Be a Pro Game Mode. And if you feel a little bit isolated, don't worry, we all do. You can't check the rosters around the league. You can't really see what's going on around the league besides from the message center. All you can do is edit your player, check the growth, look at what your coach is saying about you, check out the skill tree, and that is it. Which brings me to my next idea. We need a better and more immersive menu setup. Now there's a couple features that we can just borrow from franchise mode, and that would be the ability to view the opponent's lines, or at the very least, be able to view their rosters. We are in the age of the internet. Information is at the tip of our fingers, so why wouldn't our pro have access to information such as this? Why couldn't he look around the league and see what's going on? Remember your old phone system from the old Gen GM modes and stuff like that? What if that was the gateway? You had a phone that you could access to check out all the things around the league. I mean, you made that design 10 years ago. It couldn't be too hard to implement this and just push that immersion further. Now this is the Madden 20 career mode screen, the basic career mode. Look at how it looks, but cosmetics aside, look at how many options you have to keep up with what's going on around the league. You can check out career stats of people. You can look at the league records for all kinds of things. It is crazy. Now, obviously, the NHL games don't have to mimic this entirely, but I'm just showing you what EA is capable of and what we could have in Be a Pro. The next priority item on the list is a better trade request feature. As it stands right now, no matter what, no matter who you are, 9 times out of 10, your trade request will not work. Now you could make a pretty successful argument saying that from a realism standpoint, I guess maybe that makes some sense. However, if you watched my NHL 18 Be a Pro, I think it was, I was a star on the team, like almost 90 overall, and still couldn't request a trade. I had to simulate over half the season, get demoted to the fourth line for the coach to finally say that I could be traded. My point is, it shouldn't be necessary to jump through all those hoops just to switch teams in offline game mode. I don't know, maybe even have like some kind of a cool down period after you get traded to prevent trading, you know, too much. If you get, you know, traded once, you can't be traded within a certain amount of time or something like that. There has to be some sort of balance between realism, immersion, and having fun, and that's what we're looking for here. The next thing I want to talk about is the free agency system, and my oh my, does this need improvement. As it stands right now, this is what it looks like. You get a notification saying how many teams are interested in you, and I think the maximum is only 4 or 5, and then you just pick a team. Blindly, I might add. You can't check their rosters. You can't see who else they're maybe interested in. You're just picking and hoping that this team isn't complete trash. And especially if you're coming off of a 3-year entry-level contract, you have no idea what the AI has done to those teams. The Tampa Bay Lightning could be in complete rebuild mode, and the Anaheim Ducks could be the best team in the West. You have no way to know what situation you're getting yourself into when you're choosing a team from free agency. There literally doesn't even have to be some major change. Like, there doesn't have to be a cool, like, courtship program from teams implemented, like teams trying to chase you, convincing you to stay. All there has to be is the ability to look at the situation you're getting into. Look at the rosters, etc. Free agency should be one of the most exciting times in your Be a Pro's career, and as of right now, all it does is give me massive anxiety. You would almost literally have to keep up with all the most recent transactions, have to stop the sim before you get to free agency, look through all the teams, see their contracts, and try to maybe guess which ones will be offering you something, try to remember all of that, and then maybe make an informed decision. It can be simplified, and it can be simplified for not very much effort whatsoever. Just add in an option to be able to view that team's roster. Simple. And while we're on the subject of contracts and money, this is my last high priority item on this list. We need some form of in-game currency that come from contracts and endorsements. As it stands right now, your contract money is absolutely useless. You can't do anything with it, so you might as well take the least amount possible so that the GM can build a better team around you. What if there was some form of conversion rate from money into this virtual currency which you could spend on experience upgrades for your player, or maybe trade in for specialty points and talent tree points, you know, on the skill tree? That would be awesome. If that were the case, there would be incentive to want to take a larger contract. And it would also give you sort of an award system for your play throughout the years. You know, it's not just a grind anymore. You're working towards something. And this brings us to the last part of this video, which is the lower priority items. Now, these are things that aren't technically needed, but would be really awesome to have implemented and would still help out with the game mode and the immersion in general. And these are going to be listed off in more of a lightning round fashion, not going to go into as much detail as I did the last ones, but you'll still get the basic idea. I think it would be cool to have an option in the settings where if you simulated a full game, that would mean your player was scratched. Now that would give you more control over the role your player would, you know, kind of play on the team and things like that. We see it all the time in the NHL. Those young, you know, bottom line players don't play every game. The next idea I had was some sort of team loyalty perk. Now, right now, basically, you want to be changing teams as much as possible, usually to switch things up, but team loyalty perks, you know, you can get to captaincy faster, you can get chemistry with the guys around you so that they play better. Maybe over time you can, you know, get into the coach's ear, have an option to help suggest team strategies, or maybe that should be limited, you know, to captains and alternates, but at least have some sort of clear path to captaincy, because as of right now, I have no clue how to become captain. I think it just seems to happen randomly. Next up would be more in-depth interactions with the coach and GM. Now, this is a bit trickier because you're kind of getting into more of the cinematic type stuff and where Madden 20 is at and things right now. But if you think back to NHL 14 Live the Life, there was a lot more immersive stuff in that mode than there is now. That's 6 years ago. Correct me if I'm wrong, but we shouldn't be moving backwards. Now, this next one ties more into the promotion of the mode itself, but it would be a reward system. Kind of like how in World of Chell you can actually get Hockey Ultimate Team packs. What if playing Hockey Ultimate Team in World of Chell would give you some of the in-game currency used in Be a Pro, and vice versa? If you play Be a Pro, you can get Hut rewards and World of Chell rewards. The next thing I want to talk about is a position-changing feature, and I think that kind of speaks for itself. The ability to change positions would be nice. And last but not least, the pipe dream. The NHL All-Star Games and Skill Competition. Now this is a pipe dream because it'd probably take a lot to implement, but how cool would it be getting selected for that All-Star Game, being able to participate in the skills competition, and then the 3-on-3 tournament afterwards? Oh, that would be so cool. Thank you guys so much for watching, and let me know what you think in the comment section below. Did you like my ideas? And let me know some of your ideas as well. It's gonna take all of us to get EA's attention on this. If we want Be a Pro to be better, we're gonna have to take action and let them know. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and as always, I'll see you in the next one.